Welcome back. This is the third video in the Snagit Basics series. In the previous tutorial, I showed you how to capture an image and share it via email. In this tutorial, I will show you how to add a callout to your image. Callouts are great for drawing attention to an area of your capture. To start, move your cursor over the red capture button at the top and click the icon that looks like a pen and paper. This will open the Snagit editor, giving you access to the image you captured in the previous tutorial. Now go to the top of the screen and make sure the Draw tab is selected. The Draw tab has many tools you can use to personalize your image capture, including arrows, stamps, and callouts. To add a callout, click here. This changes the current Styles menu to the Callout Styles menu. This displays the default callout styles for Snagit 11. You can see additional styles by clicking on the More button here. Once you see one you like, click on it. Don't worry if it's not exactly what you want. I'll show you how to change it later in this tutorial. You can tell you're in the callout mode because when you hover over the canvas, there is a small callout attached to the mouse cursor. Move your mouse over the area of the canvas where you want to place the callout. Then click and drag your mouse to place the callout. If you didn't get the callout exactly the right size, it's okay. Just click and drag these dots, we call them handles, to adjust the size of your callout. See this green dot here? When you move your mouse over it, the cursor changes to a curved arrow. Clicking and dragging this handle allows you to rotate your callout. If you want to move your callout, just hover over it until you see the cursor change to the four-headed arrow. Then click and drag it where you want it to go. This callout has a tail. You can adjust the tail using the yellow handles. Adding text to a callout is easy. Just double-click and type the text you want. That looks good. You can stop this tutorial here and just use the default callout styles, or you can keep watching if you want to learn how to customize your callouts using these menus. You can use the Outline menu to change the color of your callout. As you hover over the different colors, you can see your callout change color. Pick a color you like. Using the same menu, you can also change the width of the line or the shape of the callout. The Fill menu allows you to change the color inside your callout. You can add or change a drop shadow in the Effects menu. Adding a drop shadow to a callout helps it stand out from the image. The images in the menu indicate where the drop shadow will display with respect to your callout. This one will place a drop shadow on the lower right corner of your image. Now that's a nice callout. We have covered some of the ways that you can customize your callouts. Play around and see what callout styles you can come up with. If you've watched the first three videos in the series, you know how to capture an image, add a callout, and send it via email. To practice, why not send it to me at e.smith@techsmith.com. I would love to see what you've come up with.